How are you doing, folks? This is Chris Desi, CEO of Silverback Social and founder of the Westchester Digital Summit. I'm here with the ridiculously good-looking Brad Wilson, the chief marketing officer of Travelocity. We've been friends for a bunch of years. Firstly, thank you so much for coming here.
Oh, you're welcome. Thanks for having me.
Secondly, wow, you blew everybody away. What an incredible story. What an incredible journey you've been through with Travelocity. I don't want you to have to like regurgitate everything that you just covered there, but I feel like, and we discussed this earlier before you even came to the summit, how unique the story is and how people almost dismissed you guys, saying they're down for the count. Maybe like walk me through like the dark days. Like, were you always confident that you could pull off what you pulled off at Travelocity? Like,
yeah, it's a great question. I think the simple answer is no.
Right.
Yeah, I think that the arc probably goes like this. I think in the first 6 months, you know, we were private equity backed. I came in, you know, you see a lot of things that gives you confidence that you can turn something like this around. And then you come in and say, oh boy, this is a little mightier than maybe I expected. But, you know, lucky for me, I had a lot of good people who chose to follow. I think once we started to get real consumer insights, some of which I shared up there on the podium, it became clear that we had a way to break out. And the category was changing pretty immensely, not only with what Google was doing, but you had a lot of people spending a lot of money coming into the category, as well as, I think I call them meta search engines on stage, but it's companies like TripAdvisor and Kayak that all of a sudden are commanding all new presence. And so all that wraps up to say that we developed a distribution strategy where we could be in place, where we had a fundamental gap against the rest of the competition, but we struck a nerve with that campaign and we got in places that people didn't expect us to be with Go and Smell the Roses and some of that social media influence that we
talked
about.
Did you stumble upon it? I mean, was this something that you feel like was, you know, you use like sports analogies, was just like the blocking and tackling, like you got there because you had certain disciplines that you were executing from marketing, and then all of a sudden, boom, this hit.
No, I wouldn't say we stumbled upon it, because the blocking and tackling, as you put it, we were heavily disadvantaged compared to the competition. So when you consider conversion rates in the category, we were about half of the competition because our platform was just outdated. Our inventory was about roughly a quarter of the competition. So we just couldn't compete in the quote-unquote traditional ways in which those online travel agencies compete, which is largely through TV and Google.
Sure.
So for
struggling
us,
big checks and just going crazy.
Yeah, that's right. So we had to take a bit of a different approach. I felt pretty confident, one, because we had a character and icon that could do a lot of things that the other competition couldn't do. And then two, as the market started to shift and, you know, Google, while still very, very relevant, it became equally as relevant, particularly on the lodging side with hotels, to get with and forge partnerships with companies like TripAdvisor and Kayak. I felt like we had a way in because we started to make sure that we had data hygiene on the properties that we were feeding over to them, and we had a process by which we could do much quicker bid automation at first. Mm. That's a lot of kind of jargon, but in short, I felt like we were more agile in that marketplace as it started to move.
So obviously this doesn't happen overnight. And it doesn't happen because of one person. You talked about the team surrounding you. I'm gonna shift gears a little bit, because as an entrepreneur, I see it. I mean, it's so important. I mean, when you can have one person that miraculously does the job of 10 people, and you're like, how did I not see that? And why did I have those 10 people there previously? Where are you finding your talent? And how, like, what goes on internally there for you guys to have such a drastic turnaround? And was it via your network, or what, like how were people finding you, or were you finding people? I'm just curious. It sounds
So I was fortunate. I had 5 people follow me from previous experiences. Okay. So that's the first piece. And by the way, I think, you know, it's a little different than New York. It's a bit easier to get talent in New York versus, hey, I love Texas, I love Dallas, Texas, but it's a bit harder, right?
We love you, Texas. We love Texas.
So yeah, I was very fortunate to have a few people which we've had the pleasure of working with before follow. And, you know, frankly, because there were certain parts or pockets I couldn't bring in direct. And, you know, I had a couple of relationships in the past of some agency partners that filled in some blanks for us that helped us scale out of the gate as well.
Incredible. So I have to just tell you, I mean, what an inspiring turnaround story. amazing to hear how well you're doing. What's next for you guys? Like, what's on the horizon for you?
Well, we've quite a bit. I mean, when you think about some of the gaps I was just explaining, you know, right now, I think first and foremost, I want to take care of the good team that's come over into the company. Anytime you go through that much change, it's a bit volatile. So we've had some, the team's been amazing to kind of work through all those challenges. But I tell you, we already feel very much part of the Expedia family, in large part because I told you we had that relationship from a year and a half back. So I'm calling that kind of brand inculcation, so we'll keep doing that. I think for us, you know, now all of a sudden that we have inventory X-fold higher and that engine works that much better because conversion's starting to take off, we're getting more inventory, we're getting more features on the site. We'll continue to spend more money in the US and continue to scale. We'll continue to do that unique marketing model where we can. No one else can do it in the category. I don't think anyone else is doing it in really all of marketing. When you think about who can actually get in broadcast television and get this paid, owned, and earned, I think you call it a branded viral loop, which I think is a great term. So we'll continue to do those things. And I think for us, I mean, if you look at a lot of the travel companies that are in the US, you know, there's a big presence in Europe and possibly even APAC for us to go consider. So we haven't canvassed outside of really North America. So there's big opportunity for us even in those regions of the world.
Well, I wish you the best of luck. I don't think you need luck, frankly, because you've actually killed it in the past couple of years. But thank you so much for being here.
Yeah, this is a great conference.
Really appreciate it.
Really appreciate having me.
Thank you.
Good to see you.